Hey guys, part two of mistakes that people make when they're in their 30s and their 40s is sometimes they're buying a very, very expensive car. I'm talking, 70,000, 80,000, 60,000 car, which a lot of people, they feel good about that. Whether you're going to buy your own home or you're going to look for an investment property, the thing is, you should buy your home first, and then that home can help you buy the investment property later. Can help you buy the car that you really desire later on. But if you do the reverse, let's say you buy that car and you take a big loan, like 30,000-40,000 loan, then it does affect your borrowing loan capacity, and then you might not be able to purchase your own house or an investment property. So something to think about. But on the reverse side, if you buy the house first and then buy the car later, it's actually easier to get the car loan easier than a house loan. So it's always priorities first. You want to have an asset first. Car is like a, you need the car, but it's more of a depreciating asset, even if it's an asset. But it's like a depreciating thing. So you want to buy things that are going to grow in value, or they're going to give you some income, and then not, and then buy the car, your dream car, whatever you want, and then you'll be able to get the loan more easily. Okay, so all we're asking is to reverse what you're doing now. Buy the house first and then go for your car if you really want to have a new nice car. Okay, thank you.